Hi, welcome back. This is the second week of your MOOC on learning how to do digital edition using the TEI. Before you start doing the transcription manuscript, after we have seen the basics, meaning XML, TEI, and how to do a basic visualization of that, it's time to look at what you mean to do with your digital edition. You start to do some modeling and some analysis. So before you start typing, actually, it is a very good idea to spend some time with your material and thinking what you're going to do with that. We start by considering essential activity, like you need to plan your work ahead, how much time you have available, set aside time and resources for that, and schedule and stages of your work. So if you're going to do all at once or in small pieces. You need also to do a good analysis of the material you want to edit. So why you want to edit, what you want to edit, which is the difficulties there, how big it is, do you have it available already, and how the work will actually do bit by bit. On you go. The big problem normally people have while encoding with TEI is to know where to stop. In fact, TEI offers so many elements. You will see some of them during this week and some other in the next weeks. 500s, I mentioned, sometimes even more. So where do you stop? Where do you think that's enough details I want to record? And that's very difficult because, remember, every element you add to encoding, it will add time in your encoding, in the processing, it will add storage, it will be more difficult to manage. So be careful not to add too much stuff to your encoding if you don't need it. It's also true, the other side, that if you don't encode what you want to do, if you won't encode the thing you want to process, you will not be able to use them. So this is a very delicate moment for your encoding. You need to choose wisely what you want to encode. So when you look at your document, you may want to consider some codicological features at the beginning. For instance, the structure of the gathering. Does it matter? Doesn't? Running titles and page numbers. Do you want to record them? There are different page numbers. For manuscript, it's very likely that is the case. You have blank pages sometimes. Do you want to record them or not? Do you want to consider line breaks as well? Or do you want to go transcription without? Then you may want to consider writing features, for instance, abbreviations, expansions, allographs. Do you want to record long S's and the distinction between U and V or the I and long I? Those may be not important or maybe, depending for who is your public and why you are doing the work you are doing. Textual features like division of and headings, you want to preserve them or you don't care. Do you only care about the text being represented line by line as in the manuscript, or you are interested in the structure, the textuality of your text? What about the addition, deletions, and all the features that we find in the text? Once you have decided what to do that, it is also important that you look actually at your manuscript. You see here we have an example. It's a beautiful page of a manuscript of 14th century of Dante's The Inferno with a comment. If you look at this page, we can see, for instance, that the main text is actually the one in the center, which has written a bit larger. But we have also a text on the side, the two green blocks there. This is the comment. So when I ask you how many columns of text are here, are they two or are they three? Here is the moment you have to decide if you want to transcribe both the comment and the text, or you want to transcribe only one of the two. And that is very important. You see also there is some miniatures, some drop capitals. Do you want to preserve them or not? Maybe if you are an art historian, this is actually the reason you came to this manuscript to begin with. But if you're doing a critical editions, perhaps it's not the most important things you wanted to preserve. There is also foliation, so there is a number on the top, on the right-hand corner. Maybe you want to keep that, you want to keep the foliation that is original. Maybe you want to keep the pagination as well, so foliation and pagination, or both. That's all choices you need to do. Once you go to the more into details of your text, you may want to distinguish paragraphs. In this case, it's not paragraphs, actually, it's terzines, because it's a group of three verses, and verses in each of them. We see there is correction, we see there is indentations, we see there is things written on the margins, different hands, there is a doodle. How many of these information that you can gather is actually important for your encoding? And then is when you have to go at the end and plan your edition. Plan your edition by deciding how much you will correct, if you will regularize the orthography, delineation, the capitalization of your text or not. Which type of edition are you building? Are you doing a critical edition? Are you doing a documentary edition? Or are you doing both? The answers to all these questions will translate into what we call a model or encoding model, because you are doing your edition as a way of encoding it. And all of these answers correspond to the presence of an element, of an attribute, or a group of both. It is very important also you think of the final usage of your material, which is your public, if it is for scholars, if it is for the general public, or if you want your edition being for both. The answers, again, are very, very important, because you may assume that scholar understand some things, but not general public, so you may want to add more things. But again, be careful, be wise in your choice.